Attention, citizens.
Hello. Welcome back, my friends. If you're new here, I am Lance, and this is the Reactor Spotlight series, where we watch our favorite reactors. It's a reaction inception. Today, we have a subscriber request by Lucario. Lucario. Am I correct? I probably butchered. I apologize. Lucario. You request, I know I'm probably butchering that. I'm so sorry. You requested Zavid's Two Wong Fu Thanks for Everything, Julie Newmar. And I am surprised. I had to look in my archive of videos. I swear I thought we did this. I was like, this should be one of the very first reactions I've ever done by Zavid. This is so surprising. And no, the only one I've done by Two Wong Fu was Pugapillar. Check that out. It was a great video by Pugapillar. I reacted to, but yeah, that was the only Two Wong Fu. I swore I reacted to it. It was Pugapillar I was thinking of. I do so many videos after a while, it's just, you know, shoot me. So yeah, we're going to check out Two Wong Fu, but this gotta be so damn, this gotta be like another Clue moment. You know what I'm saying? Another Clue moment, because I live for the Clue reaction. So show love to Lucario for requesting Zavid's Two Wong Fu. So I'm really excited to see this. I'll leave the link for Zavid down below so you can check out his channel, look at his archive of videos, or show him some love, because like I said, he works hard to edit and entertain us with these videos. So of course, show him some love. And of course, if you like to support me in the Reactor Spotlight series and the channel to grow, because we're almost there, almost at 4,000. I have a Cash App, Venmo, and Super Thanks. You can give me a tip on by me. Coffee. Also, you can become a channel member, Lance's Bestie, or you can head over to my Patreon and become a patron. I just put up the movie Abigail. It was absolutely fantastic. It was like a sleeper hit for me. I'm so glad Twitter didn't ruin it for me. Usually they ruin it, like they're trying to ruin Deadpool and Wolverine. I have not seen the trailer yet. I don't want to see no spoilers. I've been seeing stuff all over the internets, and I'm like, you guys are killing me. So anytime I know David and Nick just, they were on Twitter saying that they were actually at the movie theater seeing Deadpool and, they were seeing Glitter. But anyway, Zavid said he saw Wolverine and Deadpool. He said it was fantastic. So a lot of good things. I heard the movie Twisters is really good too. I want to see that. I heard that's doing great in the box office right now. Also, I'm getting ahead of myself. Anyway, also, I have a gaming channel, Let's Be Gaming. Check that out. Also, I'm on Instagram and Twitter. So anyway, let's get right into this. I act like I'm new to this. You know, also helps out with the algorithm. Leave a comment. If you don't know what to say, just leave.
The Queen is very sad today. They're closing the 99 cent store, and that's my favorite place. It's very therapeutic. And they had the best wipes, and now they're gone. Very upset.
All right, now let's check out Zavid. Two Wong Fu, Thanks for Everything, Julie Newmar.
You know, I don't mean to be a
light,
but some of y'all ain't gonna make it in tonight. I'm very sorry. I'm very sorry. I don't mean to be that girl, but some of y'all are gonna have to. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but this is for the queen.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Is this? Did we not get the title card today? Is this an intro bumper? Like a teaser? Sometimes some of these girls out here trick me with this. I'll be like, oh, they're not doing an intro, and then, oh no, that's just a little teaser bumper right in front of the video. I was like, girl, you just trying to confuse me.
Queers and the gals, okay? I'm very sorry, but some of y'all are gonna have to go. The heterosexuals, there are some heterosexuals that can come in. Yeah, you can come in. Yeah, you can come in. But some of y'all, yeah, I see you. Yeah, some of the straights, this is a different story. Some of y'all are gonna have to go. And if you wanna come in, you're gonna have to prove that you're not a straight, so bend over.
Oh. Just
hello,
gloves
the queens. It is I, the one who has more legs than a bucket of chicken pin. They have a seat. Zany. Calm down.
Calm down.
How you doing, girl? How you feeling? You feeling good and sexy?
Well, I hope so, honey, because this is one that people have been requesting, recommending.
Oh, I bet.
Some of y'all have been recommending it like as if I did not know that this movie existed or have, like, I've never seen this movie. I'm like, have you seen my channel before? You must be new. You must be new. Because, girl, I grew up watching this movie. This is one of those movies that I grew up watching, like with Charlie's Angels, Death Becomes Her, The Birdcage. They're just a group of films that I just grew up like, I did not know a world where these movies did not exist. When somebody's like, let me recommend this, I'm sure you would love it. And I'm like, you'd have lost your mind. Like, I would get my license revoked if I didn't know about these movies.
Yeah.
The gay mafia is real. I don't play with them, honey. No, ma'am. I don't play with them, honey. They show up to your...
Yeah, because I heard Elton John is the head of the Velvet Mafia, and I don't want Elton John up knocking on my front door. Let him sing. I want to hear him sing, but I don't want him to start kicking my ass.
What was I talking about?
Oh, Tu Wong Fu. Thanks for everything, Julie Newmar. Baby, this movie, oh my God. Like, how could somebody just hate this movie? Like, I understand that maybe it's not your cup of tea. Maybe you're more into the, you know, butch stuff. I don't know. But this movie is just pure joy. This is the type of movie that I watch when I'm feeling blue, when I'm feeling down, when the trade ain't coming over and, you know, I douched and everything and they bail on me or something. Now, I haven't seen this movie in... From beginning to end, I haven't seen this movie in about 2 years. The last time I saw this movie, like, fully, beginning to end, because sometimes they be giving it on TV and sometimes I'll, like, catch a scene or two. But this last time I saw this movie from beginning to end was when I first... Oh my God, almost 3 years ago.
I don't give a
Because the last time I saw this movie was when I first started my YouTube channel. This was the last time I said... Ooh. It doesn't matter how long it's been that I haven't seen this movie or something.
For me,
you just remember the lines, you just know the scenes, you just know what's gonna happen. It's kind of like writing a dick. You don't forget. Anyways, because I don't want to waste any more time. I just want to get into this bitch. But before we do, my queens, if you enjoy me and if you're not homophobic, then why don't you just like, subscribe, and ring that bell? I mean, what's the tea, sis? Like, what you doing here? But I ain't judging. Anyways, queens, let's not waste any more time. God bless Patrick Swayze, bitch.
RIPs in chat, guys, for Patrick Swayze. RMPs in chat.
Oh my God, I'm so happy.
Ready or not, here comes
Mama. And where is the body?
And where is the body?
Not here, you scrambled egg looking bitch.
Not you scrambled egg looking bitch. I love that. I love that text of speech. Isn't that what it is? Text to speech. You type it out and then it talks in that Alexa language. I love that effect. FYI, shout out to Salt and Pepper who did that song. A lot of people don't give Salt and Pepper their cred because they're the very first female rappers out there. Let's not forget that. They're the first queens of rap, folks.
Period!
Because I'm going faster than you can drive.
Too many things.
God. I'm sorry, I can't.
I know, this is my car. I'll shut up.
I am body beautiful. You know, I gotta give it up. You're not gonna catch me giving men props for doing the bare minimum. Straights, you know, straight men. But my God, when watching this movie, this is, you know, when some people say like, oh my God, why are you guys always complaining? You know, when people say, when people bring up the argument, like, we want to see more queer actors playing queer parts. This is one that I'm like, oh no, 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 no. Please give me Patrick Swayze.
Yeah,
give me John Leguizamo. Give me Wesley Snipes. Like, I can't, you know, this is one that I'm like, the same with Birdcage with Robin Williams. You know, obviously, you know, Nathan Lane is big old queen, but it's just the matter of let's have it on an equal playing field. Of course the straights can play gay, of course, except for trans. That's different. Like, I wish a bitch would bring pose and not just see Scarlett Johansson showing up as Blanca.
Oh, like, girl, no.
Excuse me, bitch.
I'm taking
Coco Peru.
Coco Peru. Check out her channel. She has some fantastic funny. She tried to play GTA, girl. Coco Peru tried to play GTA 5. That was hilarious. You gotta check that out. I think I even reacted to it. Check it out. I think I even reacted to it, I think.
When it Miss Congeniality.
Valentina's not there?
You don't love me.
You don't love me.
Oh my god, I miss going to drag shows. Oh my god. Lady
Okay. See who we got here. Now I know she's someone important. Someone told me I forget who she is. I know Lady Bunny, but this is no one really mentions in any of the reactions this queen right here, Quentin Crisp, a well-known writer. I remember hearing about Quentin Crisp when I was a teenager. The Advocate or Out magazine had an article about Quentin Crisp right here. So I shout out to Quentin Crisp right here, okay? I want to know that no other channels have recognized Quentin Crisp right here. That is a queer writer. Why am I closing the screen out like I'm done recording for? I am so... See, I had a little devil's lettuce, so excuse me, I might be a little slow here.
Bunty! Ugh. Let me tell you right now, Lady Bunny is the most rotted human being to ever walk this earth. I mean, just filth. Disgusting. I mean, can you imagine just being around somebody who makes the most inappropriate jokes? Like, the most inappropriate comments, always talking about sex, just filth, and always turning a tragic moment into some sick, low-hanging fruit of a joke. You know what I mean?
I wouldn't have no idea who you'd be talking about.
Put your hands together for Rachel Tension!
That's a pretty well-known porn director right there. Shishi LaRue. This is Shishi LaRue. Shishi is a well-known, got in a lot of controversy too, with a few of her porn actors. I don't think it was essay or anything like that, but I think it was just like, I don't know. She did someone dirty on Maury Povich or something. I don't know, some reality talk show thing, controversy. Those were the days, right?
I mean, whore, mother, you better work, bitch.
In the Confederate flag dress.
Sure.
Only RuPaul.
Do you know just the idea, a black gay drag queen coming down in a Confederate flag dress? Bitch, you know, it's just insanity. I love being gay.
I don't know who he is, but if there's a snowstorm tonight, he's going on my tires.
Ooh. I have no idea what the fuck that means. Still, after, what, 25 years?
Girl, you live in New York, and you have no idea what that means? Okay, for some of you out there don't know, in the north, when it snows, you get black ice and all that, and it's all the roads are all slippery and whatnot. A lot of people put chains on their tires so they kind of breaks up the ice and have a little bit more traction and stuff. You put chains on your tires. So that's what she meant. She wouldn't put him on her tires. But you see, had chains all over them. That's the reason why, girl.
Excited, I could just spit.
I usually swallow.
Oh, ho, brother, ho, whoa, 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 now. You got too much dip on your chip.
We have a tie.
I'm not going to say nothing about that.
Tie? What does she mean tie?
Noxima Jackson and Miss Vita Bowie.
Girl, Trinity and Monet still have PTSD. You still can't watch this movie, honey.
I couldn't think of Trinity. I was thinking, I remember it was Monet and who else, the girl? Oh, yeah, Trinity.
I don't know if it's the nasty competitor in me, but the thought of a tie,
I wouldn't
bitch,
be
I'd
happy.
Rather lose. Because I don't want to share nobody. I'm Patti LaBelle. I only want to be one crown. Bitch. No, ma'am.
Find out why that little Latin boy in drag is crying.
Little Latin boy in drag.
Why are you crying?
You're so pretty.
That song.
Oh, yes, yes, of course.
That song.
Everybody's always laughing at me.
I love that girl.
But maybe I'm going to meet somebody nice.
Oh, bitch.
Girl, get with us. Now, how are we going to do that?
Sell our plane tickets and the three of us go by bus.
No, ma'am.
That chaw is Latin. She might turn out to be a Sandinista or something.
Not a Sandinista.
Honey, no, ma'am. I ain't trading my damn tickets. I was bad enough I have to share with one other bitch. I ain't share with another. Mm-mm.
I wish it was as beautiful as you.
Oh, honey.
Good luck.
Oh. Good luck. I get it all the time, though. People just stopping me in the street saying, please, how are you this beautiful? Like, you know what I mean? It happens. Oh. Well, you don't know. But it happens to me on a daily basis. Oh.
All right, that was it.
Que bellissima, come va?
Darling.
Oh, shiver, you spoke French, how bad.
I bow to thee, honey.
Ay, papi, ay, tan chulo, mamita. El gusto es mío.
No, no, no. We have decided.
Fabulous.
How about chemin de fer, train?
Does it have a club car?
Tell me, does it have a club car? For me, if it looks like Murder on the Orient Express, like, you know, that's what we're talking, honey. But I ain't gonna be like one of that Sex and the City episode, remember? Well, I don't know if you remember. I don't know if you watched this. That was that one episode when Samantha and Carrie went, what was it, to San Francisco? And they were like, oh, yes, it's gonna be first class, honey. It's gonna be bougie, honey. Girl, they show up there, they have the shower on top of the toilet. I'm like, no, ma'am.
I'm starting to understand why there was a murder on the Orient Express.
I'd rather watch San Francisco.
To our sort of...
Oh. Not these days, girl. You heard it's more homeless people in San Francisco than actual folks. They're all moving out now in San Francisco. That's what's going down in this world these days, girl.
Oh, bitch. Julie Newmar has been watching silently over this entire conversation. And you were the only Catwoman.
Period.
I mean, they were looking at Julie Newmar. I was looking at Ethel Merman. I mean, it's Ethel Merman. I mean, come on.
Oh, Lord.
Young beast.
Shut when you think about it.
It looks like it comes down to that age-old decision. Style or substance.
I do have to say, so far, on 9 minutes into this video, how he edited down and made it coherent and still enjoyable and hit all the key parts, right? It's great editing on that. Because I know this kind of movie would be so hard for me to edit because there's so much good stuff. And he can only put so much in for YouTube if you want to make it. And I got that money, I'm fine. You know, it's you want to keep the lights on, you know what I'm saying? It's nice. And have, you know, entertainment like a streaming service so you don't pull your hair out, you know what I'm saying? So, to edit this down and try to have these key parts is so good for people who just want a quick, don't want to watch the whole movie and want to be entertained by someone. It's like a good Judy, you know what I'm saying? So, give David his flowers, just what I'm saying.
Gotta leave this town, gotta leave this place. Oh, shit. Leave this place.
Oh. I thought I missed
something. Oh, shit.
With the crick.
She has a new album coming out soon. Release Me Volume 2. Release Me Volume 1 came out when I was in high school. I remember that. Being good isn't good enough. And she had a bunch of
other. That's wonderful. I love that for you.
I'm about to lose my shit, bitch.
Girl, I'm good.
Why are you good?
Gorgeous. Stunning.
Why?
Ugh.
This is a hard. That's hard to see. That's rough.
Maps are cheating.
That is just so idiotic to me. Like, I have never, and I understand it's always like a religious thing, and you know, it's like throwing away your kid because they gay and shit. Like, girl, this is the most stupidest thing. Like, you could have a beautifully decorated house if you would just keep your gay son there. I don't understand. Like, girl, what you doing? Now, it's different if they're ugly. You know, like, yeah, obviously, like, throw them out. Nobody wants that around.
Electric chair.
Nobody wants that around.
When a gay man has way too much fashion sense for one gender, he is a drag queen.
That's right.
I'm just a boy in a dress.
Definitely. Oh,
absolutely. I don't need this.
Look at her running like she's running across the border.
You know, Miss Chi-Chi, she has a lot of potential. You know what I mean? Like, Miss Chi-Chi thinks she's Valentina, meanwhile she's just Serena Cha-Cha. You know what I mean?
Oh, oh.
The shade of it all.
Oh my, that, ooh. Why is that so damn true?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. It's just so middle America.
People are going to be cruel to
middle
us.
America.
Get violent feet, and you know we've been there before.
Trust me, I know. Especially after the wife finds out where her husband and I are staying, and then she makes a scene, and then she brings out a gun, and then the housekeeper starts taking pictures and all that stuff, and I end up on Facebook, and it's like a whole mess. But I got time for that.
Who are you looking up with, Elon? housekeeper.
Okay, let's move on.
You'll meet many of your friends inside.
I'm running out of a fucking double wide trailer. Housekeepers and shit.
Friends?
Friends? Friends.
Well, get with the program, mijas. No one is so rich as to throw away a friend.
Basketball!
I gotta remember that one. No one's too rich to throw away a friend. That's a cute line. That's a really cute line.
Some shady shit going on. Just some shady bitches. Like, okay, so what if some of these female basketball players look so butch that they can open a beer can with their pussy? That does not... y'all are just shady. That.
Lost in the hot embrace of Damien sinewy bronze flesh.
Bitch, driving in the night road, especially being me from Dominican Republic, bitch. I remember being a kid and somebody, I forgot who it was that told me, like, these, like, scary stories, and they would say, like, there would be, like, nuns on the side of the road, like, in the middle of the night, like, that's waiting for somebody driving by to stop them and kill them or something. Like, ooh, that shit traumatized me. Girl, can you imagine driving in the middle of the road, like in the middle of nowhere, and you just see a nun just waiting for you? Bitch.
We are three young career girls. Career girls.
This is Sean Penn's brother, by the way. Chris Penn, I believe his name is. This is Sean Penn's brother. Sean Penn. That's a whole ball of crazy right there. Him and Madonna together. Oh, could you imagine that relationship? That toxicity.
You know, we don't go for that around these parts. White girls riding around with and
Aunt Vita, talk to the man. You speak honky.
Ooh, girl. I feel like I'm on TikTok.
Ooh, oh.
Get your hand off my dick, buddy.
Ooh. Well, I mean, he had it coming. Why it was raggedy, greasy-ass pig rubbing up against me like that? You crazy. I mean, I am easy, but at least ask. You know what I mean?
He had his hand up my dress and...
There was an interview with Patrick Swayze. I hope I can find it. He said in that scene when he was supposed to grab, like he was supposed to act like he's grabbing, you know, he put a cucumber down his pants as a prank. And that was supposed to be a true reaction. Like he went up there and he grabbed that. If I can find that, I'll throw that in here. Because when I heard that, I was like, oh my, could you imagine that? That is a true reaction. That'd be hilarious.
No, he wanted to know where she got her panties from.
Mommies, don't quote me, but I think this one is this season.
I ain't not this season, girl. Baby, let me tell you something right now. I would have taken off all his clothes. I would have taken the gun. I would have taken his wallet.
We already committed murder. We might as well rob his ass.
I would have left him naked and doused him with honey. Let some bears take care of him, huh? Probably take him in as one of their own. Oh, yeah. Yes, I would have taken everything, honey.
Where are you going to find honey at, girl?
When I was stuck here forever, I knew
I
didn't ask to come on this trip, did I?
No, I don't think so.
How you gonna hitchhike, huh, if there are no cars, stupid?
I'm the Latina Marilyn Monroe.
I got more legs than a bucket of chicken, pendeja de gracia. But now, can we talk for a minute, though? Talking about Miss Julie Newmar, I want to have a discussion with y'all. I want your honest opinion. Who you think is the best Catwoman? I want a real tea, bitch. Now, personally, when I think of Catwoman, there are three that come to mind. In no particular order, Michelle Pfeiffer, Eartha Kitt, and Julie Newmar. Let me tell you something right now. They are so different, but they have so much in common because they are just, it's just sex. It's just the sex appeal, the beauty, irresistible to men. I mean, no, I'm not talking about myself. I'm talking about Catwoman.
This one needs to clean her mirror.
Oh my God, that no one can touch. Not Anne Hathaway. Now, I'm not judging whoever you say is the best Catwoman, but if somebody says Anne Hathaway, I might block you. But I love Anne Hathaway. I think she's great. But bitch, she to the queen. That is Miss Eartha Kitt, Miss Julie Newmar, and Miss Michelle Pfeiffer. But no judgment. I just want to know who.
I'm not a big fan of and I love Halle Berry, but I did not like the Halle Berry Catwoman. I'm glad you didn't mention I love me some Halle Berry. Storm, when she was Storm, I love that. Baps, when she was in Baps, love that. When she was, not so much. I forgot about Anne Hathaway being, I thought she was Batgirl, but that was Winona Ryder. No, it's that chick from Clueless. What's her name? Bang Bangladesh. Let me know in the comments, you guys. Let me know in the chat, you guys, since we have a chat. I've been saying chat, haven't I? No, we've never done a chat. It's in the comments. Check the comments. Girl, I'm a little slow myself.
Who y'all think is the best Catwoman? I can't say who's my number one. My number one, I would probably have to agree that it is Miss Julie Newmar, because she has this feline look, and the waist is like this. The proportions and the face is just like
that. Waistline and is that waistline is giving homegirl drag queen Valachowski. Yeah, Valachowski. She's giving Valachowski. But Valachowski's, it was crazier skinny. Oh my god.
She walks, if you watch the Julie Newmar Batman's Julie Newmar, literally I'm just watching it in awe, and I'm like, how is this human? The sex appeal and the way she talks, oh.
I can give you more happiness than anyone in the world.
That's all y'all need.
Ooh, my nipples are getting hard, bitch. Wait.
You need a ride?
And I just need to go pick up my friends, alright?
Look her little bitch, that's on some movie.
Cause that, if that would ever happen to me, honey, or me hitchhiking in the middle of the middle of nowhere, girl, I end up tied up to some basement fighting for my virginity, honey.
That is for sure.
Well, ladies, welcome to Snydersville.
Girl, this is them doing a Katy Perry concert.
Then why don't you buy her music?
This is the presidential suite.
Well, if she writes anything good anymore, I probably would.
You know what I think? The last black person to stay here was Sam Cooke.
Oh, girl, when I was a kid, I didn't know who the fuck Sam Cooke was. Until I Googled what happened to Sam Cooke in the motel. Girl, I was like...
That's a shame. Yeah, girl.
What? Girl, yeah. I'll tell you this right now, honey. Thank God I wasn't the housekeeper that day, bitch, because I wasn't cleaning up all that mess. Look up what happened to Sam Cooke if you don't know what happened to Sam Cooke in the motel, bitch.
I love roughnecks. Mm. If I was your pet, would you be my bottle?
These are the type of boys that are around my area. Take a good look. That's what's around my area. This is what I gotta choose from. These kind of country boys. So you see what the kind of, you know. This one right here. This one right here. I've seen quite a few movies. I would definitely. Not husband this up. I would definitely not husband this. Maybe. But this one would be my pick right here. This guy's not too bad, too. Actually, all these guys are probably... You know what? Let's just keep going. I'm not...
Go on.
Sound like a whore.
Me.
We were wondering if maybe there were some historical points of interest that we should not miss.
Whore, there is a pink and white trailer park in front of you. I don't think this is a place of high society.
Hi.
Her and her husband have had sex for nearly 7 years.
7 years? Girl, that pussy must creak.
Sounds like me.
Are you crying?
No, just chopping onions.
Oh, may I?
I wish a bitch would put their mouth in my spoon, bitch. I would be like, I don't know where your mouth been.
Virgil does like his way, doesn't he? I can't help but observe right
Virgil.
Now, there are no chopped onions anywhere.
Bitch, Virgil needs a knife up his dickhole beating up Stalker Channing. You crazy, bitch. Stalker Channing, can we take a minute to appreciate the excellence that is Stalker Channing? I mean, a 65-year-old woman playing a high school student. Oh, the talent. Nobody can play Rizzo like Stalker Channing.
Oh, yeah.
Sucking cock all through the night.
I know it's been a while. Is that real lyrics of the song? Now, come on, David. Are you going to gaslight me today on this? Come on now. I thought we're girls. Come on now. I got to revisit that today, then. I don't remember that song. Place for a home.
Restaurants for brunch. That is wrong. That is just wrong. I mean, he didn't have a glory hole or a bathhouse or something. Just inaccurate.
Like Zima Jackson?
Not Zima.
Mm-hmm. Jesse's daughter.
We are working on decorations for the strawberries.
Jesse's daughter.
We all make strawberry pies. And we eat the strawberry pies. And we go home.
It better be strawberry pies. You better not put no rhubarb in there. I will beat that plaid out of these women. I hate when people say, this is a strawberry pie and it's rhubarb. Tell me, rhubarb. I lived in Pennsylvania a lot of my first 9 years of my life as a child. And I remember the Amish used to love making that rhubarb pies and stuff and call it strawberry part. Girl. Because they would put strawberry and then parentheses rhubarb. And they get fooled me every time because rhubarb has a twang to it. That's the best way to describe it. It has a like aftertaste twang. That's not like, oh, what is that? Especially something that looks like red celery, purple celery. I mean, have you ever seen what rhubarb looks like? Look it up. It looks like purple red celery. And they make that into dessert type of, girl, no, come on now. Oh, my dad used to tell me stories about how one of his relatives used to make rhubarb. He hated that stuff. And I could tell why.
Ooh, girl, you better calm down. Y'all wildin'.
What do strawberries say to anyone here?
Ugh, when you shave your legs and then that strawberry look on your legs, that's disgusting. That's all. That's why you have to exfoliate and all. Yeah.
Oh, girl, I have no idea.
A day with the girls.
A day with the girls.
What's a day with the girls?
Well, maybe you start off the day with a little bit of yoga, you know, a little bit of exercise, then you have a nice breakfast, or maybe like a nice brunch, you get all drunked up, honey, hire a hooker, take turns riding him, honey, and then you go to his friend's house, and then there's a gang.
Much luck!
If you ever wonder what I look like thrift shopping, yeah, this ain't far off.
It never. And she never said.
I don't know, but for me, I've always found a stutter charming. There's something so endearing and sweet about a stutter. But I guess that's because I've met a lot of men that have stutters and I find it really charming. Well, they don't have stutters, they just become speechless whenever they take a look at this beauty, honey.
Who is this chick? She reminds me of this one professional wrestler. I probably said this before. Athena. That's who this chick looks like, this one professional wrestler. But I know that's not who that is. Is this one of the Braxtons or something like that? Let me know in the comments. Because this chick, it looks familiar. And she looks like a professional wrestler. But I don't think he would throw any professional. He doesn't seem like the type of gal that throw in professional wrestler type of memes and shit.
Come on, grab my Moses, give it to me.
That's right.
Got to turn it out.
Cute.
Ooh, check yourself, Loretta.
Gorgeous. Oh, I love the pattern on that dress, bitch. Ooh, very poochy. Girl.
Still too spicy.
What's wrong with you? Did you?
Here, put this on.
Oh, no.
Earlier she put paprika in it, right? He's the type that would think mayonnaise would be spicy. You know what I'm saying? He's that type. If you think paprika is spicy, you need to go to bed. You just take a nap. Just have a seat.
Yeah, it's too big.
Honey, it can never be too big. Here, put this on.
Oh, yes, I can. Tell it to my aunt. Oh. Honey, my aunt went from a donut hole to Play-Doh that was left in the summer sun.
Come to ask somebody out of sociable.
Well, I declare.
I declare.
I decline.
I love that.
Might be going out with Mr. Bobby Ray.
Well, now we got a lot in common.
Like, for starters, the same business in between your legs. Boink, 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 boink.
Girl.
I'm staying, okay?
That's for sure.
Miss Jennifer Holiday.
Don't forget surprise on him.
That's right, honey. Baby, Chi-Chi done lost her damn mind, honey. Because you know how it goes, bitch. They go down there, honey. They see that Binga, bitch, and you end up on the 5 o'clock news.
Yeah.
Virgil's beating up Caroline. We have to help her.
There are times when if you help people, you end up being killed.
That's right, baby. I am not getting involved in no damn fights and no No, ma'am. Because let me tell you what happens, honey. I end up getting a knife up my ass, and I am not... Let me tell you something. I may be nosy, but what I am not is about to get involved in the middle of a fight. Bitch, I ain't nobody's bodyguard. Do I look like Kevin Costner? No, I ain't getting involved. I'm calling the cops, but I'm not getting involved. Not this delicate flower, honey. No, ma'am.
Ooh, what the hell?
Ooh.
She did that in Kid in Heels, too. Give Patrick Swayze her props in Kid in Heels, knocking down doors like that.
Some ladies need to get hit.
Some men need to be hit back.
Oh, ooh, that's right, bitch.
Baby, I wish a man would put his hands on me. Let me tell you something right now. If a man ever put his hands on me, baby, let me tell you something. I would wait until he fell asleep. I would put that iron on steam right in between his legs, bitch. Ooh. Let him hit a Mariah note. Girl. But I mean, I had a man once that put his hands on me. Yeah. No, I don't talk about it a lot, but it was like, it was intense. He liked, you know, he liked the choking and the slapping and throwing across the room and all that stuff, honey. I mean, I would have kept seeing him, but he moved out of the country, so.
Look, honey, thank you for dinner. You've got to let him hear it sizzle.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, that is correct.
Right. But honey, I could open a damn steakhouse and ain't no man coming over. Sorry.
Work.
Bobby Ray, come here.
Bitch, you got cataracts? Woo! Chi-Chi, bitch.
Would you like to dance with me?
Sometimes it just takes a fairy.
It's him. You know, I do have one problem with this movie, and I want to be serious for a minute. I just don't like the way that they just portray, like, gay men as being, like, this flamboyant, over-the-top, effeminate man. Like, come on, not every gay man is like that.
Definitely
not. Men wanting to be with one another. Men touching each other. Rubbing up against one another.
Ooh.
Touching each other.
Ooh. Excuse me a few minutes while I jerk off.
If we're going to be friends.
You hear some dude. He's just talking about touching him. Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't get jumped. Like, dude, I think you got some, you need to have some issues you're working out, my friend. I think that's what you have. You have some deep-seated issues.
There really is something I should tell you.
Adam's apple? Women don't have Adam's apples.
Then you know?
Honey, Helen Keller knows.
Mm-hmm. Don't protect these freaks! These boys in dresses!
This bitch needs some head. Like, girl, get a f***ing life.
Yeah.
Girl, bro.
He needs a
whoever belongs to this shoe, come forward now!
There's something so sinister yet so fabulous about a red wedding-like dress. Oh my god. Oh, my nipples are getting hot just thinking about it. It's just so, I don't know, it's so sadistic. It's so twisted, but so fabulous at the same time. I don't know why. It gives me like very like Beetlejuice meets like Night of the Demons kind of vibes. I was gonna say
Beetlejuice.
That shoe is mine.
She's not the one.
Bitch, shut up.
I am a drag queen.
Oh.
I love that outfit. I would have cut it a little bit shorter so I can show the stomach, you know, bitch. But I live in that headband. Ooh.
I'm a drag queen over here.
Ooh.
You have no idea how dangerous these people really are.
Girl, they're drag queens, not from Al Qaeda. Ooh. Come on, give it to me, bitch. Gorgeous. Ugh. Come here.
Oh, ooh, everybody have a good time.
I love this movie so much, I can't. Get out of the way, bitch. Do what you wanna do. Who would dare hate this movie?
I love you, in spite of who I am.
I've waited my whole life to hear those words said to that name.
Vita's dress. Yo.
I'll tell you this much, honey. Miss Patrick Swayze learned how to walk in them heels, bitch. He was like, you ain't gonna catch me slipping, bitch.
Mm. I don't think of you as a man.
And I don't think of you as a woman. I think of you as an angel.
I think that's healthy.
I'm still waiting for one of the queens as an exit line, like when they got eliminated. They just turn back and say, Rue, I don't think of you as a man. That would be so funny. Oh my god. Anyways.
That would
gorgeous,
be good.
Gorgeous. Stunning. Oh my god.
Step four, larger than life.
Who wants to play with black and white when there's all these colors in the rainbow, bitch? Ooh, gorgeous. The skin, the shade matches the skin tone. Stunning.
Miss Julie Newmar.
You look good, bitch. Brava. Brava.
That was so good.
Hercules.
Was so much fun. I am so glad we got to check that out. He did a great job editing this video. He did a great job entertaining us. He had the great one-liners. This was a great video. This was really good. I had to roast them a little bit, but the chains on the tires, because a lot of people didn't know that. If you don't live in the northern states with snow and stuff like that, you really have no idea like what that means as far as a joke. So I get that. But I had to roast a little bit though. But this is so much fun. I always like to relive these little moments, because sometimes it's like, oh, I don't have time to watch the whole movie, but it's nice to get like a Cliff Notes version. Cliff Notes. Who uses that word? Anyway, Cliff Notes version of it. And with someone that you would think it would be like a great Judy. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Take care of yourself. Take care of each other. Love, peace, and grace. And bye.